If you're looking to level up your productivity with an amazing project management tool, but you have no idea where to get started, you're gonna love this tutorial because I'm gonna walk you step by step through the process of creating a simple but super powerful workflow that will level up your productivity to no end and save you a ridiculous amount of time with Trello. Let's get into it. All right, so let's head over to Trello. This is the first thing that I want you to do. Awesome. So after you have your Trello account set up, the first thing you're going to want to do is set up your workspace. You can do that by clicking right here and naming your workspace. This could be anything that you want it to be called, whether it's your business name or a particular department. I already have a demo workspace set up here. It's called marketing. And then from here, we're going to want to create our first board. So once you click on boards, you'll see that it will prompt you to create your first board, and you can title it whatever you want. Usually I do something like to-dos or my workflow, something along those lines. Now you're going to see a completely blank board, and this is where Trello's greatest weakness and also their greatest strength is. You might be like, oh my gosh, this is totally blank. I have no idea what to do. Don't worry. I'm going to show you, and it's very simple. So the idea with Trello is that you're moving from left to right, moving tasks from left to right in a Kanban workflow. And so we're going to set up a couple different lists, and we're going to keep it super simple. It's going to be the first list, very basic, to-dos, and then we're going to move into doing, and then done. Once you have those three basic lists, the next step is just to add cards to your to-do list that you want to accomplish that week. Now, a good brain dump here would be very, very helpful. And so just brain dump everything that you're going to want to work on this particular week. Do not judge yourself. We will talk about this in detail, but I'm going to go ahead and fast forward so that you can see how this is done. All right, awesome. Now that I've totally outlined what I want to work on this week, as I'm doing it, I will move that particular task here from the to-dos to doing, and as I complete it, to done. Remember, each of your tasks or projects is represented on cards, and these cards are really easy to edit and change up. So let's talk about cards and how you can leverage them. I love about Trello that you can add a quick description. So let's say that there's instructions that you want to collaborate on with a team member or with a client, or just have notes for yourself. You can just add notes here, and then you can add bullet points here as you go along. And that way you have stuff that is saved right here on the description. Now, if you wanted to collaborate with other people, you can add them to this particular board and they will show up here. Now, I'm the only one on this board, so I'm the only one who's showing up, but you can also add yourself if you're collaborating with multiple people, and then that will give you notifications on due dates and all that stuff. Now, with labels, I love using labels, and you can customize this in a variety of ways. You can say, okay, I'm going to categorize my tasks based on department, for example. So you could have an admin label right here. And then you can say, okay, this is going to be an admin task, or you can have a marketing label. This is going to be a marketing task. Or you can categorize things based on function. And this is how I like to do it. Like, for example, you could have a delegate, which is very helpful, particularly if you are the head of your firm. Even if you're a solopreneur, delegation is so key. And then also you could have important or priority, right? Boom, right here. And so I can go in and easily change out the labels, and I can also see them if I click right here on the label view. I can see the actual text. So you can click here to hide them and then expand them. That just helps me really stay focused. And on a different workflow board that, by the way, you get access to this one. It's going to be linked in the description box below. If you want this free workflow board, you can absolutely get that. So another great example of labels here, as you can see, is making sure that you're focusing on tasks that only you can do. So for me, I like to have these labels that give me that visual cue of like, hey, this is a four-figure task. You should be completing this, versus maybe a two-figure task or a one-figure task here that I can delegate to my team. That helps me stay focused on profitable tasks that are going to move the business forward. And of course, if you want to download this free Trello workflow board, absolutely do that. It's going to be linked in the description box below. You can just enter your name and email, and we'll send you a copy of this Trello template that you can then import into your own account. How awesome is that? That's pretty great. All right, so back to our cards list. Let's explore now checklists. Let's say that you have a task that is going to take a variety of steps. That's where checklists come in. And so you can literally just type in to do and then have a multiplicity of steps. For example, if I'm writing a sales page for our new TBL coaching program, I can say, okay, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draft the copy, and then I'm going to proofread, and then I'm going to design it on the website, and then I'm going to send it to the team for review, and then we're going to create a product on SamCart, which is our checkout tool, and then we're going to write the emails for the promo, and we're going to launch. So this is an oversimplification, but it's just an example of how you could set up multiple steps. And then as you complete them, you'll have a progress bar right here at the top that shows you where you're at in terms of your progress, right? So we're moving things here to doing, and then you can see on the front of this particular card how many steps you've accomplished out of the total, which is super helpful. Now, let's also talk about due dates, because what does not get scheduled does not get done. And so as you go here, you can always have due dates and set them up here. You can set reminders for yourself if you want a reminder, let's say 5 minutes before this task is due, or a day or two before. You can select that right here. So I'm going to click save, and then we're going to go into the attachments part. Let's say that I want to gather ideas for this particular task. So I'm going and I'm checking out other websites, or I'm linking my own for a different particular page that I want to model. I can always click on attachments and then paste or attach a URL, name it, and let's say this is our shop page, and then attach it right here. This is particularly handy if you have a task that entails multiple steps, or you're collaborating with other team members and you want them to have access to all these different resources. Now, it's really handy to have them here in the attachment section, but you can also just comment down here and copy them over. So that's really great too. Now, of course, if you want to attach something directly from your computer, you can go ahead and do that. Let's say that I have this design that I want to attach and it's going to be part of the sales page. Boom, it's right here for everyone to see. We can also attach things from Google Drive, Dropbox, Box, OneDrive, or Trello itself, which is really helpful if you wanted to, let's say, add a different task and connect two cards together. You can do it really easily right here. Next up, we have power-ups, and this is such an amazing way to take your productivity to the next level, but this is a whole nother video, and we don't have time to cover everything that is related to power-ups, so I'm going to link a related video that I've already done on my top free power-ups for Trello down in the description box below, so you can check that out. But one of the ones that I definitely think you should use is the calendar power-up. So to find that, just you can easily just go into the search bar and type in calendar. From here, you'll see the calendar power-up. You can add that. And at the time of this recording, it's totally free, which literally makes your boards look so much better. And so before I actually show you the calendar view, I want to go ahead and add some due dates to all my individual cards so that you can see how the calendar view really comes in handy. All right, so now that I have a bunch of due dates for the majority of my cards, I'm going to click on the calendar power-up, and now I can actually see all of my tasks and my cards on that calendar view. So you can see it right here on the month view. We can move them over if we need to, and the due date will automatically be updated. You can also click on them right here to expand them and see them in full view. Let's say that you want to add a bunch of different labels. You can do that here as well, and I just love being able to see everything at a glance so that you can see what the due dates are. Now, you can also see this in week view. So let's say you just wanted to focus on what you have to do that particular week. You can add new cards right here from the bottom and create a new task right here. Edit it, move it around, customize it to whatever you need, and that just makes things a lot easier. So again, using the calendar power-up, I think, is a must. And so as you build out your Trello board, you're going to be able to keep track of everything that you have going on in your business. Remember, you can set up a new board for a particular project, or you can use boards for collaborating with clients or a team member. there really is a limitless opportunity to create a workflow that really resonates with you and works for your style of productivity. And so as you move cards down the done list, et cetera, you can really have control over how you operate, because the idea here is to not work so hard, but to work smarter and to make use of every single minute that we have at our disposal. Now, let's talk about this workflow board that we have for you that is totally free and how this is a little bit different, because again, I want you to make this process your own. It's not about just modeling exactly what we do, but making it fit to your particular style. So for example, we always teach inside the Business Lounge and we tell our members, hey, you need to be setting goals for the week every single week. So on Monday, you can use a list called Goals for the Week, for example, and then you have a bunch of different tasks or projects or things that you want to accomplish during that week. Then you have your daily to-dos. And so every day you can move your cards from the Goals for the Week list over to the daily to-do. So let's say that these are right here, right? And it's Monday and I'm like, okay, so today I'm going to work on these three things. And then as you move them along on the board, you can have other things on your board. Let's say that you have ongoing projects and these are things that are a little bit more complicated, but maybe don't require an entire board for this particular project. You can have things that are coming next, right? Maybe like a idea shelf or tasks that you know that you want to get to, but are not necessarily a priority for this week. You can have things that you want to outsource, maybe things that are not urgent, things that are only related to clients, future projects, a whole list just for ideas, resources, notes, wins, sales copy, testimonials. Really, the idea here is to customize it to your own individual business and make it your own. And instead of getting overwhelmed and not having a great productivity system, I want to challenge you to open up your mind to what possibilities are out there. I know that you can do this. I've taught thousands and thousands and thousands of students in the business world to level up their productivity through our programs, and I know that you can do it too. And listen, just to give you a teaser of everything you can accomplish as an entrepreneur, you can have entire board just for projects like we do in the company, where we literally manage every single thing that we have going on. And listen, there's so much more you can do in your organization, for your business, or for your brand. For example, we manage all of our big fat projects right here in our Trello board. And we call it that just lovingly, but really this board has everything that we're creating in the business, from our low-level requests for our team to really big, complicated projects that we're running. You can even do things like having a content calendar, and we teach all of this inside our programs. And by the way, there may or may not be a Trello course coming soon, so check all of those details on the description box below. So see, this is our content calendar, and we literally run all of our content pieces through this particular board. We have other things like our content bank, and our training library, and our systems and processes, and our assessment boards that all really make a big difference for us to be able to run a company in a way that just makes sense. So all of our training is here for our team, how to basically do everything, systems and processes in our business. There's an entire content bank where we save all of our social media posts and we get to reuse them for later. And I teach you all of these tips and tricks in our upcoming course. So definitely check that out, as well as our Trello templates. All of that will be linked in the description box below. All right, so I hope that you're seeing how easy it is to set up a clear, concise, and hyper-effective productivity system and workflow for your business. Not just that, but all the possibilities that can be achieved with Trello as you start developing and building more processes and systems for your entire business. Here's a question of the day. What else would you like to learn around Trello and productivity? Leave it in the comments section below, and don't forget to check out our Trello course, as well as our Trello templates. All of them will be linked in the description box below, because I can't wait to show you how you can level up your productivity. I've been doing this for over 10 years and teaching thousands of students how to level up their entire workflow so that they can save up to 10 hours every single week that they get back, so that they can use to build their business or spend more time with their family or friends or do the things that they really love and are good at. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next episode. Bye for now.